In this video, we're computing a pretty tough integral. It's the integral of x times the square root of 1 minus x to the fourth. And it turns out this integral requires u substitution and then trig substitution. And then we're going to have to use some trig identities to clean things up at the end. So we start out looking inside the square root and going, man, I wish that I had something squared here instead of something to the fourth. And I can rewrite it that way because x to the fourth is just x squared squared. So the plan is to let u equal x squared, and that would give me the right form to use a trig identity inside of that square root. It'd be 1 minus u squared. It's critical that you have this other piece hanging around in front in order to get the differential of u. So the derivative of u is 2x. I've got to have that x piece in there if I'm going to transform my differential. So I make my u sub. I let u equal x squared. That means du is 2x dx. And all I have to do is pop a 2 into this integrand, and I've got du. There's the 2x, there's the dx. Of course, you can't just go around multiplying things by 2, so I make up for it out in front by putting a 1/2. So now I transform my integral in terms of u. And this is good. I have a 1 minus u squared inside that square root. I recognize that this is a trig substitution type integral. If I let u equal sine theta, I can take advantage of a Pythagorean identity to simplify that interior. One extra thing I want to do at this point, because I know I'm going to need it at the end, is I go ahead and solve for theta. I know at the end of this integral, it's going to be in terms of thetas, and I have to get all the way back to x's. So theta is the angle whose sine is u, but u is x squared. And we'll save that for later. So I make my trig sub, and I get square root 1 minus sine squared theta times du, which was cosine theta d theta. Then I apply the Pythagorean trig identity. Just a reminder, cosine squared plus sine squared is 1, and that means cosine squared is 1 minus sine squared. So the inside of that square root simplifies to the square of the cosine function, but then I square root it, and I get another copy of cosine. So this whole thing turns into a cosine. The second copy of cosine is over here, and I'm left with 1/2 the integral of cosine squared theta d theta. Now this is a classic trig integral that requires an identity. So as it turns out, cosine squared is 1/2 times the quantity 1 plus cosine of twice the angle. I'm going to pull the 1/2 out in front while I'm working. And that gives me a 1/4 in front. So I can pretty quickly find the antiderivative of each of these pieces. When I integrate the cosine 2 theta piece, I basically get sine 2 theta, but I have to adjust with a factor of 1/2 to account for what the chain rule does. Now if I differentiate this piece, I'll get back to cosine 2 theta. And I should put a plus c in here, but we're not going to get to the final answer for a while. I'll just remember to do it at the end. So the problem isn't done because it's not in terms of x. And now is when I go back and figure out how do I replace theta in terms of x. It's the inverse sine of x squared. And this piece is trouble because we can ordinarily get a trig function of an inverse trig function, but a trig function of twice an inverse trig function, I don't know what to do. So we need to use an identity on this. The sine of twice some angle, in this case the angle whose sine is x squared, is equal to twice the sine times the cosine of just that angle. The factor of 2 is going to cancel that 1/2 out in front, so that's nice. And I end up with the sine of the angle whose sine is x squared times the cosine of the angle whose sine. And the sine of the angle whose sine is x squared, well, that's just x squared, so that part is simple. But the cosine of the angle whose sine is x squared, that requires us to draw a triangle to visualize this angle. So here's the angle whose sine is x squared. And the simplest way to do that is to make the opposite side x squared and the hypotenuse 1, so the sine of that angle is x squared. I want the cosine of that angle, which means I need to get this adjacent side. And with practice, you can start guessing and checking these, but just to show how it's done formally, I use the Pythagorean theorem. Question mark squared plus x squared squared, which is x to the fourth, is equal to 1 squared, which is 1. So my missing side is the square root of 1 minus x to the fourth. So I keep cleaning things up. And remember the sine of the angle whose sine is x squared. That's just x squared. The sine and the inverse sine undo each other. And then the cosine of the angle whose sine is x squared. That's the adjacent over hypotenuse for this triangle, which just gives me a square root 1 minus x to the fourth. I could leave it that way, or I could distribute the 1/4 and remember the plus c at the end. And we're done. If you find the math content on Zach's lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.